tu es le champion wrestler du Corée, you are called Isiburu. Isiburu, you know? That is, you've beaten everybody else. So that is a painting of Adisibu. Now, Eberi is a basket he's carrying with a pot, a mystical pot with some medicine inside, you know, part of his power. Then, on one hand, he carries a big, huge bell, with which he announces his arrival in the arena. So all his opponents will start shaking. Then the other hand, on his left hand, is carrying a mirror with which he'll see the result of the bout even before it starts. And the thing in his mouth is a medicinal root, which gives him extra strength when he wants to wrestle. The wrestling thing is something that the Ikwerre people cherish. To be an Isiburu, you have to wrestle for some time, 7 years or six, or unbeaten. Then you retire as an Isiburu. So when you retire as an Isiburu, you retire unbeaten. If you get beaten in the seventh year, then sorry. Yes. These days, it's not as celebrated as it used to be, but in the when we were younger, and Isiburu very well was, if you manage to survive the 7 years, the people will now celebrate you. They build you a house, and then furnish it for you. They marry a wife for you. Oh yes, they ask you, whom do you want to marry? You say, it's this woman here. And they ask her, do you like him? You say, yes. And of course, most girls like his Isiburu. No girl will say no. Then, so they will get to the parents and actually marry the woman for him. Then get him CDMs to start his farming. So Isiburu was a prestigious thing. And it made you for life. If you managed to survive the 7 years that you were Isiburu, that made you for life. All these things, you have the honors, and then you have all these material benefits coming to you. Yeah.